You're listening to the home of the Saguaro Sabercats on AM 1060 KDUS, the Varsity Sports Show.
Welcome back. When you hear that intro, it's none other than the Sabercat Report. Scottsdale Saguaro High School Sabercats head boys basketball coach Lucas Ramirez joins us on the line. Coach Ramirez, how you doing, sir?
Doing well. How are you?
Coach, happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day to you guys.
Coach, I saw something on Twitter last night. Brittany Boyer, one of our broadcast partners, pointed something out to me and told me that I had to make fun of you. And I thought, man, I don't have the heart to make fun of anybody, let alone a great guy like Lucas Ramirez. And I say that tongue in cheek because I make fun of everybody, but because I get it back in droves. But Coach, you were sitting in your class. Tell us about the serenade you got yesterday.
Yeah, our choir department, our talented fine arts department, they go around, you know, during Valentine's Day, and you know, they sell serenades. You know, students can get serenades for their peers, and you know, I have such a lovely administration. You know, Miss A and Mr. Harris thought it'd be great to give a serenade to myself and head football coach Jason Mond, and they got it, you know, on tape. So it was a fun moment. And by the way, we have talented kids, on our campus that aren't just athletes too. You know, really fine musicians. So
it was pretty cool
to see them showcase that.
Well, we have to get that kid on sometime. I don't even know if you have his name, but next time you talk to him or see him around campus, we need an official violinist here on the Varsity Sports Show. And this kid, he was pretty good. And you just, you know, you looked, more than anything, you looked embarrassed. And it was classic because you're in the camera kind of off in the background and you dropped your head and you looked like you were laughing a little bit. But that truly was, that was amazing. It was great to see.
No, without a doubt, we'll have to get the young man on sometime.
Yeah. All right. So let's get right into business here. You guys had a big week this week in terms of not so much the fact that you played a lot of games. I mean, you had the one home game on Wednesday, but it was a big win. Talk a little bit about that 5-point victory over Poston Butte.
Yeah. I think I'm still exhausted from that game. So it's good we only played one. I can imagine how the kids feel. They're a really good team. They play very fast, and they did a good job catching us really off guard with their transition. We had a really poor transition defense. I don't mean to start off so negative, but I'm honest. We were really bad getting back in transition. But again, you know, we fought through adversity. Got to learn to finish games. You know, we were up 10, 12 points with a couple minutes left, and you know, we had a quick trigger there. But can't speak enough about the performances from both seniors. Caleb Simpson, he had 29 points, 6 rebounds, 4 steals. And then senior Davion Irby, 16 points, 11 rebounds. And those guys kind of led the stat sheet, but really everyone who played a big role in the victory. But great win, but we're on to Seton Catholic next Tuesday.
Coach, is it fair to say that this matchup against Poston Butte was the toughest test that your team has faced this season?
Oh, I mean, if you ask the kids and people around, you know, we try to have the mentality of every game we play, the next game we play or their current game in front of us is the most toughest opponent we've had. It's hard to compare. I mean, it's human nature to compare, but yeah, I mean, they brought an element I'll probably say they probably were the fastest team we've played in terms of style of play, but every team has something that's a little tricky that we try and take away from them, you know, to get them out of what they're doing or what they're used to doing. But I'd say they're the fastest. I would say I'm never going to label someone as the toughest or, you know, whatever it is, just because the mentality, the next one's always going to be the toughest.
Coach, I think in watching this game, two things emerged that I hadn't seen that we hadn't seen in previous games. And it was the emergence of your inside play. I mean, that really struck a chord. You've had guys in the past, Tristan Mondays played really well inside, but what you got from Kavion Irby, and we were a little, there was a little concern early because he got into some early foul trouble. You had to sit him for a while, but then you brought him back and you kind of used him sparingly and wisely so that, you know, to make sure and keep him out of foul trouble the rest of the game. But that guy was a beast inside. And I, when he dunked the ball, coach, in the, you know, late in the fourth quarter, I about lost it. I about had a heart attack. It was amazing. It was an amazing play. And then Caleb Simpson and everything he did throughout the game. So I know you had mentioned those guys earlier. To talk a little bit about both of them, you know, in a little more detail.
Yeah. With Kavion, I keep telling people, because it's kind of funny. I mean, I'm starting to notice a little bit, hey, man, you know, Kavion's playing better and better each game. Or, you know, he had a great game the other night, this, that, and the third. And, you know, I always tell people, you know, he keeps getting better and better. Every game we play, he's bringing something else to the table, you know, getting in better shape, getting in better position to rebound the basketball, you know, the disrupting shot on the defensive end, or just, you know, putting easy 2 points in there. It's funny you mentioned the dunk. I mean, obviously not everybody can hear me, maybe. But as he got the ball in transition, I said, lay up, lay up, lay up. And then he just dunks it in there. And, you know, one of my assistants turns to me and says, how about that for your layup? So it was a funny moment, you know, in the heat of the battle. And you know, it's funny, you know, that changed some momentum for us for sure. That's what dunks do. But, man, oh, man, I wish we had a student section in that, at that juncture. I mean, the place would have gone nuts. I've been around basketball, as you guys know, for a long time. But that was a pretty powerful jam. I haven't seen a powerful jam like that in the high school level, I think. So that was exciting. And Caleb, I can't speak enough about him. You know, he's been dialed in and he's grown up a lot, you know, these past few months, you know, and he keeps playing better and better basketball as well. He's becoming more and more patient. He's, you know, playing harder on defense little by little. You know, you have to keep reminding him he gets to play defense too, but I mean, he has been playing great basketball lately, probably averaging 20 points or so, a little over 20 points the last three games. He's playing his best basketball right now, but again, he's doing it while being patient, still being a good teammate. You know, he's filling up the stat sheet with assists. But, you know, again, I can't speak enough about those guys. They work hard every day. They show up on time. They do what they got to do. And I mean, the results show when you do the right things. And so I'm proud of both young men.
Coach, currently your team's sitting at 7-1 overall, and it's kind of crazy to think, but we are vastly approaching the midway point of the season already. What would you give as a report card so far to your team in that first half of the season? And what do you hope to see improvement-wise as we quickly approach the second half of your season?
Ooh, report card, Greg.
Midterm.
I have trouble putting in my own grades in my own classroom, so now you're giving me an extra grade to put on. I would say – actually, I'm not going to give you a letter grade because, you know, I just don't.
Incomplete.
I'm nervous about this stuff. I'm superstitious about it. You know, I'm pleased with where we're at. You know, we have a lot of work left to do. We have a very high ceiling. We have a chance to be a very, very good team. I think our best basketball is ahead of us. I think if you ask people, whether they be inside or outside the organization, there's people who were surprised with the early success. But, you know, when you have kids buy in, you're going to be in a position to have a chance to win. And we've been in those positions. Unfortunately, we've done little things along the way to pull out those games. But, you know, overall, I'm very pleased, but I think our best basketball is ahead of us.
Coach, I've been talking about this a lot, and I know that you're probably getting sick of hearing this, but when to hear you speak about, you know, your philosophy and coaching and the whole X's and O's, you sound like a guy that's been doing this for 30 years. But you know, let's call it what it is. You're a young guy. This is your first head coaching job. You've worked under some great coaches in the past, and you've got a roster full of guys. You've got 11 out of 13 on your roster are seniors. Now, you got a team that won all of four games last year, and all of a sudden you got them to buy in. And that doesn't happen. It doesn't happen with a group of guys that have been together, that have been let down, that have experienced disappointment in the past. And all of a sudden somebody to come in, oh, here's another new head coach. He's saying all this stuff. He's going to, you know, rescue us and teach us how to win, but it's happening. How?
Again, you know, like I told them from the very beginning, and I'll tell anybody this, you know, I don't have all the answers. I don't know everything there is. We have a really great staff. We have a really great, and I think most coaches wouldn't say this. It's very important, though. We have an administration that cares. You know, Miss A, Mr. Harris, Miss Pena, Mr. Milligan. I mean, it starts with them. Like, there's a vision of, like, we want to win. It's not just we want to support you and do whatever we can, but it's no, like, we need to win. Like, these boys need to win. They deserve to win, you know, if they do the right thing. So their vision's aligned, you know, with that as well. And on top of that, you know, I think I answered it to you guys, it may have been somebody else, but these kids were hungry to win. These kids were hungry to be coached. I'm not saying anybody could have done it, but, you know, credit goes to the kids, you know, because I think just a great perfect storm of, you know, people involved having seats at the table. And, you know, I can't give enough credit to our coaching staff. They do such a good job. They make me look good. You know, my name goes in the whatever, the Twitter, the MySpace, whatever it is. I'm kidding. I know MySpace is
MySpace. Holy smokes.
But, but, you know, my name's on it, but I tell you what, man, our coaching staff's so good. Our administration is so great. Our players are working their tails off. You know, it's a collective effort. And again, we've had things go the right way for us. And we've had adversity and we've found a way to get through it, but long way to go. 8 games in 14 days coming up, which is, man, I need to get some rest, but you know, we're looking forward to it. We're excited.
Yeah, and that's what I was going to quick ask you about, Coach. One game last week, a handful of games this week. Is your team ready to play pretty much every other day this week?
Well, I'm sure they're thrilled not to be in practice. but yeah, no, I do think they're ready. They know what it is. They know what this next stretch means. Every game is valuable. Every team is beatable, but every team also could beat us, you know, and I think that's what's really unique about, you know, not just our region, but 4A. Yeah. There's a lot of great coaches, a lot of great programs, a lot of talented kids where anybody can beat anybody on any given night. You can't come in arrogant. You can't come in entitled, you know, and you just got to bring your shovel and pail ready to go to work.
Coach Lucas Ramirez, the Sabercat Report, head boys basketball coach, Scottsdale Saguaro High School. Coach, good luck. We'll talk to you next week.
Thanks. Go Cats.
All right.